axiom for pomegranate. By D.C. Demars. This way about you glints above your head like dawn, a sacred purgative. These days it is clearer than it used to be. The same glint hinting about the universe in us to be. Restless to reveal its ecstasy in you that was axiom unto yourself so long, and for me to only guess so long at with my male demonstrations of still ingenuous tenderness, while you gained it more as miles superseded miles, until you and I both knew we could not be erased, and our love could not be erased, of all the hard work has brought us the personal wisdom we need. We need our keepsake to reflect and chart our circuit. A guerdon for the wisdom living in sashes of vine where the pomegranate grows. We sink our throats in it. In its delectable, gratifying wine curtained by hard flesh. The cranial scarlet cells within that throb salute. Yes, it was always there. You desperate mendicant, you. Searching for vessels of thought to give meaning to your life. Well, you have a thought we have made. Your love that hungers for the better spirit of yourself. For an ever upheaval. An ideal that sat so long in you. This tendency now is a final worthy manifesting form that says more in being than one might assume on first glance of your impregnable smile that rocks the world to sleep with its confusing meaning. Disunited with the circumstance, you and I might bicker and tear away with the frets of ourselves, each other, from what is always in focus nonetheless. Still, the music of the pomegranate sings its chord from out the pluck of even those highest frets. It is indifferent to circumstance because it is the wealth of one absolute fact of life that sticks and will stick around after I look away and look back at you, dear one. It is in the flicker of your guileless eyes at me that dream of their small persons in the dark of the intimidating womb. Your eyes, they tell me it is all right and that I am for you. The beginning of September or thereabouts, I'll be a father and will know my name at last for some other thing, various yet concentrated, that I'd always seen preserved like some ruin of antiquity that despite its inward years will make itself anew, as is its tendency to make anew. It is a thing sits as a stubborn pomegranate, pushing against my tired, slouching frailty, telling me irascibly to live for thee, for I do live for thee. A new interpretation of life, in your belly, getting along in the world, a girth of cells, assuming deeper shape. A wide world of dark universe. You got her into your head. I cannot leave. No, not while the poor thing sleeps and the call rests over the bones of the darling fruit. You leave me speechless. Because all of it was like looking at the stars above us. The same ones lingering in the sky this whole time. With a meaning, old as God. Her name is before us like the half-life of stars. Time stays one step ahead. This routes all possibility. This is important. And my immolation is complete. I have her now, this dastard girl, foreseeably a witness to my own bad states and good states. What I shall not leave, what the empty fates weave thoroughly. And tell me she comes from vines. Is the shock of the seed locking us beautifully from exhausting twain and misunderstanding and wild accusation? A fact grows in you. It's like a universe expanding while the twine of fates, like the vining, reveals to me this vision of our face. Anticipated meld of no sufferance ad infinitum, as I said. I think this no sacrifice, though. You I love in your own delicate call. Livid fire of my heart and flaming pomegranate. And growth of all myself. For all of you follows Margot. And you need only show yourself to me, for me, to know I love thee forever and ever. Old father, old artificer. Stand me now and ever in good stead. I need you now more than I ever have for me to be the right man for this job. I shall live and change myself, I think. I think that is a good idea. The pomegranate kicks, recognizing. Wants to be the little reeking thing that sits at play there on the stained carpet of my life. On the path to its livelihood, born into this house of hostile world, but for the both of us to tell its truth, so that Margot knows the higher sainted axiom, higher than we suggest to her, but cannot tell. Because if ever she had known magnificence, that truth would be alone, a soul of ragged fruit, weathered in the celebratory hallways. Your golden thighs, oh mercy, and Hecatum, where she can go forth and be our self, herself, for us.